Some very convenient news for the Trump administration last night. In a hastily put together presser where no questions were allowed, the Director of National Intelligence, John Ratcliffe, came out and claimed that the emails sent recently from the Proud Boys domain name were a result of election interference by Iran and Russia in order to hurt President Trump's re-election bid. The emails said, "Vote for Trump or we'll come after you." This comes from the very hyper-partisan John Ratcliffe, who seems to be hamming up a lot of this intelligence to the public. And by the way, you shouldn't trust anything that the national security establishment tells you at first, unless you're presented with evidence. But it's very convenient that this involves Iran, neocon's number one foe, and also diverts the blame from the Proud Boys.
Director of National Intelligence John Ratcliffe tonight did say to the public that this attack, which he attributed to Iran, although he didn't describe the attack, was designed to damage President Trump. That sounds like what you just said. Is that is not what he told you in the briefing?
Well, I'm not saying what he told me in the briefing. I can tell you that from the briefing, I had the strong impression it was much rather to undermine confidence in elections and not aimed at any particular figure, but rather to undermine the very wellspring of our democracy, elections. That was my strong impression at the meeting.
So it seems like, according to Chuck Schumer, there are already discrepancies in what was told in the private briefing and what was presented to the public, which means there are likely many more discrepancies. And the evidence presented here, basically non-existent. Buried in the Reuters article about this is an intelligence source saying that it is still unclear who was behind these hacks and that the evidence is inconclusive. But that's not the headline that, of course, the media ran with. And here in the Washington Post story, they say the servers came from Saudi Arabia, Estonia, Singapore, and the UAE. A reminder that Saudi Arabia and Iran are bitter enemies. Is it possible that Iran could have routed its hacking through Saudi Arabia, the UAE, Estonia, etc.? Maybe, but Iran's hackers and its hacking infrastructure are notoriously behind the times a little bit, partly because the United States is sanctioning them to death, preventing medicine from going into Iran, among many other things, and causing starvation. Would they have chosen Saudi Arabia to do that? I just think that's very unlikely. And then the other claim that Russia is trying to hurt Trump. Russia's trying to hurt Trump. Say what you want about Russiagate and that whole investigation, which I thought, I become more cynical about that by the day because I think it was really played up and it was not the most important issue. Maybe we could focus on mass unemployment, poverty in this country, giving everybody health care. Those are the issues that I think are infinitely more important than Russia. But it's pretty clear that Trump and Russia have a good relationship and the Russian government. Why would they be sending false flag emails alongside Iran to hurt Donald Trump? It makes no sense. It's almost like they tried to copy and paste the losing playbook of Hillary Clinton and apply it to Trump. As if anybody is going to be voting on these matters, people only care right now about coronavirus and the economy. And Trump is terrible on those issues, losing ground to Biden on the economy when Republicans usually have a leg up there, but I digress. Also, most voter registration information is public. So a lot of what was disseminated in those emails could be found via searches. Another hole in that story. My BS meter is going through the roof with this one. At a hastily assembled news conference Wednesday, national security officials accused Iran of attempting to interfere in the U.S. election by sending voters fake emails made to look like they had been sent by a far-right pro-Trump group called the Proud Boys. Iran had three goals, Director of National Intelligence John Ratcliffe said, to intimidate voters, incite social unrest, and damage President Trump. A chorus of Democrats, though, have pushed back on that last claim, but not the other ones. Noting the threatening emails were sent to registered Democrats in swing states and instructed them to vote for Trump or we will come after you. Given the email's targets and the demand to vote for Trump, Democratic leaders questioned why Ratcliffe characterized the interference as an attack on the president's re-election campaign rather than an attempt to inspire confusion and distrust of the entire 2020 election. But again, if you mistrust the characterization that this is an attempt to hurt Trump in the election, Why do you trust the other legs of what is being presented to you by Ratcliffe? If he's lying to you about this, he's probably lying about the other things, or at least connecting dots that are extremely vague. We've seen this done in the Iraq War, by the way, in order to present a reality to the public that benefits them politically. Iraq War, prime example, we had inklings of intelligence about weapons of mass destruction that were terrible and not vetted, and they made that seem like it was fact in order to achieve their political ends. I am very skeptical about this because it seems like the exact same playbook that the intelligence community uses over and over and over again, and the media doesn't learn. They're just headline after headline. Oh, Iran, Russian interference in our elections. Boom. Story's over. Why, though? Why? There's no evidence that was presented here. And also, has the national security establishment ever been this quick on an issue? The Russian interference stuff took years to develop, and Obama sat on it because he didn't want to seem like he was interfering in the election, and also, it was still developing. Now we have these reports of these Proud Boys emails, and immediately they're doing a press conference and saying it's trying to hurt Donald Trump, and it's from Iran, the country that neocons have been trying to start a war with forever, and Russia, so they can flip the 2016 narrative on its head. And again, this stuff about election interference. Now it's so ubiquitous and used so exploitatively. Democrats claim that horrible, stupid, fairly unethical Hunter Biden story that was still newsworthy, but also, again, gratuitously included photos of Hunter Biden from his personal computer, which was just egregious, and shady Rudy Giuliani was involved, but I digress. They claimed without evidence that was a Russian hacking operation. Has that been proven? Has there been any evidence for that? No. Now, the right-wing Trump administration is claiming that Iran is behind these Proud Boys emails, and it's Iranian-Russian interference, right? They are exploiting the years and years of Russiagate talks because they know it's now in people's minds. Election interference internationally, blah, blah. Guys, there's so many bigger issues domestically here. And the fact that this is what keeps Washington, D.C. and the elites there up at night, as we have 26 million Americans on unemployment insurance, as we have 30-plus million Americans without health insurance, as we're about to face a mass homelessness crisis, as over 60% of Americans will have zero savings or emergency funds by the end of the year. That says a ton. That says a ton. So this seems like a lie to me. I'm saying this straight up, call my shot now. I could be wrong, but I'm not gonna report on something without being presented evidence, especially when these are the institutions that have lied to us over and over and over again. And Ratcliffe is a former far-right Republican in Congress who's now making these claims. I have zero trust in this, and neither should you.